Okay, so once again, you are dead as the blue side, as I mentioned, and Beefer said they are systematically starting down south.
Yes, and pretty very standard lineup coming up from you right here, going with the single T-32.
A very Pershing, light, though.
Yeah, a little bit lighter than we're used to actually seeing there, but still very balanced. And I think it was partially due to their matchup here. They wanted to have a slightly more aggressive lineup, I think, especially since they're facing up against C. Whereas C, they do have a balanced setup as well, but I think...
They got that extra sniper.
Yeah, I still have to give a slight advantage to you right there.
Well, I mean, the main difference is that, okay, that Object 416 has been traded for Pershing on UAD side, and one of the 1390s on the UAD side has been traded for 5100 when it comes to C, so a bit more firepower when it comes to the rookie team, but at the same time, look at that, UAD is already just using like those 1390s to great, great advantage. I mean, both... okay, just you got one at least that made it
to the
entrance of the mines, and everybody's progressing east. Like, we have seen this push last week, actually.
Yeah, but it's actually very interesting to see none of the, except the two enemies, that means none of the tanks really kind of guarding that hilltop area here.
Yeah, once
and
again,
wow,
very defensive.
Yeah.
I'm not agreeing with this at all.
Yeah, almost all the tanks on the seaside here moving to the western edge here. I mean, it's currently like a east versus west kind of situation here with the T32, I believe, on the seaside
kind of
guarding
the
entrance. Yeah. So, you know, if that T32 can hold its ground, I think this should be fine. But
yeah, but you've got Kuryavka, who's like on top, sitting
exactly,
much from the mine's entrance. And you know what? Like, coming with that angle, whoever's like positioned to the western aisle is like pretty much useless because nobody's on the central hilltop on the UAD side. So if they all come out like from the eastern edge with Kuryavka squatting the mine top, then basically the T32 is not going to last.
Yeah, I definitely have to agree with you there. You know, if the You Are Dead side come out from the eastern edge, you know, the C guys are not going to be able to expect this. And look at this, Ashta here, you know, he's kind of in position to guard from any pushes coming from the hill.
Yeah, and nobody's coming.
Exactly.
I mean, it's like all the tanks like to the western aisle as well, like except for the 150 that's like camped up north, pretty much. I'm assuming it's the name.
No, the 50 is actually over here.
To the western aisle.
Yeah, it's Newton over here.
Okay,
yeah.
So basically they're wide open.
Yeah, they are completely wide open here.
Oh boy.
Yep. Eventually, when you ready to figure out exactly where the C tanks are, they're gonna go for this push, and that T32 on the C side is gonna be completely—we're not trapped, but he's at least gonna take a couple shots before he gets undercover here.
Well, I mean, they're gonna have to concede ground. I mean, no doubt, the T32 will have to retreat towards the western aisle as well, and concede the entrance of the hilltop, because otherwise he's gonna go down. I mean, there's no way he can just by himself just. Stop the UAD onslaught that will undoubtedly come from the eastern side.
Yes, most definitely so here. Onion hit it with a very nice positioning as well, spotting a couple of those tanks down to the most southern part of this western aisle area. It is the AMX-13, and I believe actually a medium tank is on its way down there too.
Yeah,
so,
exactly.
You know, as long as Onion Head just stays here, and honestly, Onion Head is enough to stop any kind of push coming over there from the west.
Or at least delay it long enough for the troops to come back. But like, I think UAD is like much more focused on a push of their own at the moment towards the northeast. I mean, they realize nobody's home.
Yeah. They have not really spotted any of the other C members, but you know, since they have not spotted any of members on the hilltop, they're all assuming that they are all over there to the west.
Yeah.
It's a very good assumption.
Exactly.
Too.
You've got Minichon, then Godcat 1's already up there, you've got Legacy Gen up there. So basically the heaviest tanks, like both the T32, the Pershing and the T69, have already made their way towards the eastern village.
Yep.
And C, once again, they're not budging, are they? They're not even trying to find out like where those UAD members are.
I think they're trying, but the thing is, maybe they're a little bit confused because none of the tanks have been spotted there guarding the hilltop area. Kabuto here, kind of making his way to the western southern part of the mines
area. Which is smart. It is a good position.
It was giving me a name here. I mean, if they want to, they can still go, you know, for the base capture as well, and even like a flanking maneuver. At the same time, it's really going to depend on how long you're going to take.
Yeah, and they're spread out thin, aren't they?
Yeah.
As well on the seaside.
A little bit, and yeah, if the Uredet, once the Uredet actually comes, the Uredet side come up from the east, they really have zero cover.
Yeah, exactly, and what's really smart is that both 1390s are actually squatting the mine top.
Yep.
Like, you've got Onion Head towards the southern slope, pretty much, that's like having a crack at the western aisle, and also the southern entrance of the mine, and of course you've got Kuryavka up north as well, having a crack at the T32, so needless to say, if there's any sudden push, like those 1390s can come back to delay this long enough, while the main forces, the medium and heavy tank, and first kill going to Onion Head.
Yeah, very nice shot there, taking out that T1. Yeah, Kabuto now realizing that, yeah, the AMX-13s are in fact up on the hilltop right now, playing a little bit safe here.
Probably like with some of the tanks too, and look at that, the northern push is slowly, well, yeah, exactly, sending the T1 first, yeah. Making sure that there's not like any heavy presence up north, but C is probably just, they gotta make a decision right now, either to come back and defend their northern position, or try to creep down south, but they're not moving. Again, they're not responding to this. I mean, there's a clear threat, pretty much. They know there's some kind of presence towards the southern hilltop area because the T1 has been taken down, and they had spotted a T1 up north as well, so they have to respond to this, and they're not budging.
Yeah, even, yeah, Ashusta here in that T32, trying to take care of that T1. You know, that's, I think, the kind of wrong mindset these guys have that they're having right now.
They're playing exactly what UED wants them. Exactly what UED wants them to do.
And look at the Ashusta. Ashusta being spotted here by Legacy Janna. The other two medium tanks on the UED side getting to position as well. Yeah, Nomi as well. Kind of making his way up here, and since the two AMX-13s on the Reddit side have control of this hilltop, they will be able to go for a flanking maneuver if they so please, and at the same time they will also be able to go back to defend if the seaside go for a push here. I have a feeling though that, you know, Reddit are just going to continue to have this slow creeping maneuver, just hiding behind these buildings here, not, you know, kind of allowing the seaside to get clear shots onto them, and eventually when they land a couple shots on that
will
seaside
push.
Yeah, they're going to go for
it's
a push.
It's pretty much a replay of Himmelflof that we're seeing, aren't we?
Yeah.
Because they know exactly where those tanks are now. I mean, yeah, because who was it? It was Onion Head. Like, he had spotted a couple of mediums to the Western Isle and the 1390 as well. So, and they know for a fact that nobody has, like, just really pushed towards their own base. So they feel very comfortable at this point.
Oh, but actually interesting coming out from Uredet, actually pulling back from this eastern side or this eastern push. Maybe they...
Once again, playing mind games, still have enough time for this, actually. Maybe they're going to go for the central hilltop.
Yeah, I think so, too.
Because, yeah, now they realize that T32 has retreated even further, as a matter of fact, so the hilltop has been pretty much deserted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the second these Uredet members come back here to contest this hilltop area, they will be able to just go for a straight down push because none of the C members are defending that at this point. Yeah, the T32, Ayushita there.
You do have to watch out for that Object 416 towards the Western Isle, though.
It should be fine, though, because, yeah, Nomi and the Onion Head really nicely defending this chicken shot there, being spotted. So the T69, now you already know that chicken shot in that T69 is down here to the most southern part of this Isle area. So, wow, they're actually all pulling back completely down to their starting position. Gonna go for the Western
Isle. Yeah. Probably. They're just, I think they just want to do a clean western sweep, don't they?
Yeah, I think so. They just want to have maybe an even engagement against the seaside, and you know, if it
I mean, mind you, like,
even...
yeah, I mean, because there's still like a 5100 to take care of on the other side. So
Muden.
A huge shot on Muden again, and there was that, yeah, speaking of devil, that was the 5100 for you.
Yeah, definitely so here.
Oh boy, once again, some clinical shots landing, like the UAV accuracy is brutal. Okay, Minichun took a hit here.
Big 1v1 battle right now.
Yep, indeed.
And God Cowan, of course, in that Pershing, taking a shot from Give Me a Name.
Yeah, just excellent bit of micro here coming from Give Me a Name, using his
Minichun
extra speed, like, just a good advantage. But
they're going
has
in.
To get out of dodge. I mean, God Cowan has to be careful. He's taking a little too much damage here.
Yeah, look at that. Minichun also moving in here. Legacy Jan taking a big shot. Chicken Shot is doing a very nice job of landing his shots.
All the way back, like, isn't he? And once again, yeah, it's just it's that T69. Give Me a Name is doing a great job, actually. Mm-hmm. I mean, he took a few hits, but by hugging that cliff and using like his extra maneuverability, he's providing vision for that T69.
Yeah, actually, I really like what Give Me a Name is doing right now.
Yeah,
it's forcing you right to come out.
Exactly, kind of, or at least like hug that hole, that cliff, pretty much, and be inoffensive on the other side.
Ashdatha being spotted as well.
Yeah,
so
this might be a replacement of
fact. I think so, maybe.
You know, UAD maybe should have stayed to the eastern side. I reckon they would have had more chances.
Oh, maybe they're going to go for this. Yeah, very nice play coming up from these two AMX-13s.
They're going to try to trap that T-32.
Oh, yeah, he's trapped. He's trapped.
Oh, boy.
Yeah,
he's going to
go down. Yeah.
Oh, once again, a brilliant raid.
Wow.
A brilliant, brilliant raid. I mean, just
waiting for the
wow.
perfect opportunity there.
And down to like 40 seconds, this is absolutely clinical. While keeping everybody busy down south, once again, even I was baited on that one. Oh, boy.
Yeah, very nice play coming up.
Look, even us with like two observers, like even us got baited. Like, wow.
I mean, I knew the AMX-13s were up there.
Well, they were up to something.
Yeah, but actually
wow.
just very, very nice timing, actually.
Excellent raid.
They waited and they didn't commit to anything, and I guess it was kind of like their joker. They're just kind of a, maybe, you know, if they absolutely needed to pull off like a last minute strategy.
Well, exactly, if the battle goes to Stray, like down south, then
they always have that option.
Yeah, yeah. And meanwhile, once again, mind games, because everybody was so concentrating on that firefight down south, including the sea tanks.
Yeah.
So the T-32 left all alone.